Yesterday on Right to Real Love Radio, the number one relationship podcast for Christians that will make you happier and smarter.
When I told girls, you know, I'm celibate, they thought I was weird. Like, why?
They ain't believe you, man.
You're not having sex? Like, what type of man does that? You know, it makes no sense to me. And they're like, so I come kiss you, you're going to tell me no? Like, I'm like, no, I'm not doing none of that. Like, you know, and it just came with its own challenges because I was questioning myself, like, oh, am I weird? Like, why I'm doing this? But I just had to keep faith, and the enemy will try to send people around you to discourage you in your walk with God. So I just stayed my ground, you know, I just held on to it. But being with Dom, it makes it easier because we're both on the same page.
Now, let's get back into the discussion.
What do you believe are some of the benefits of making that decision as a couple to remain pure before getting married? What things do you believe you guys are already experiencing and have to look forward to?
A lot of growth, you know, because I learned to love, you know, Dominique for who she is as a woman, instead of just, you know, having sex with her and taking that away from her. And, you know, just living by the flesh, because it's like you see things in a whole new light. You know, you experience things in a whole new light. It's not no more of, you know what, let's just have sex and, you know, let's continue down this path. Now it's like, God, we're doing this for God. We're trying to put a smile on his face before we please our flesh. So it's like when growth came, it changed our mindset. You know, when we just seen how powerful it was to, you know, deny the flesh, because, you know, a lot of people are looking out there and a lot of people, you know, they're like, wow, like this couple's actually doing it. And it just makes us feel like a more powerful couple doing it that way.
So growth is one of them for me. I'm happy. Like, I feel a lot of joy. And because I waited, that joy and that happiness is genuine. It's genuine and it's raw and it's from God. And it's like, for me, I couldn't get that if I had sex, because truthfully, to be told, when I have sex with a person, it clouds my judgment. I can't really think straight. I can't really see what it is in front of me. Like, my eyes kind of have like blindfolds on it. So with being celibate in our relationship, and where I feel like it's going to strengthen our marriage, is that we see each other for who we genuinely are. We're growing together and we're just experiencing each other spiritually. And to have a man who is willing to pray for me and not have sex with me, like, he'd rather lay down on his knees to pray with me than lay me down on my back to have sex with me, that is like, it's amazing to me. You know, all these things, like, is what I expect for us to have in our marriage, and to just be happy, to just grow spiritually, emotionally, and just, you know, appreciate each other for who we both are. Because, like, the love that we feel now in a celibate relationship, it cannot compare to anything that I feel with any other person. It only compares to God.
Wow, that is amazing. I really appreciate you guys for opening up and just sharing those benefits, how it's impacted the two of you, and the benefits that you have to look forward to. I truly believe that God is going to bless your union. And one question that did come to mind is kind of like a hypothetical question, in a sense, is if you were to look at the relationship that you have now, how do you feel like it would be different if the two of you had made a decision to have sex?
I think a lot of things would have changed. Like I said earlier, God gave me a choice whether to have sex or to believe in him, you know, and depending on the choice is going to see where my destiny goes. So he told me, like, look, if you have sex with her, that's it. Like, you guys are not even going to make it, you know? So I just believed in that. I just believe, like, you know, this ministry will not be happening right now. The YouTube videos, you know, me and her together, like, we would not have been able to make the impact that we're making now, because, you know, we made the choice to not live by the flesh, to please, you know, our Heavenly Father, which is always going to have a greater reward than pleasing your flesh, you know? So it just comes with, you know, just being thankful and just being able to acknowledge God for who he is, you know, able to live by his word and to trust him, you know, in all avenues of, you know, our lives.
Yeah, for me, I feel like we wouldn't be here. We wouldn't be on, you know, your channel right now. We wouldn't be having our own ministry or anything like that, because I kind of feel like it was a test. Like, God wanted to test us to see if we can stand up to the storms and the tribulations that come our way, because I feel as though if we would have had sex, we would not have been spiritually strong like we are now, because both of us come from a background where we like to please our partner. We like to do things even if it meant displeasing God. So I feel like we wouldn't be who we were today if we would have had sex. I wouldn't have loved him. I wouldn't have been able to take when we argue, when we have disagreements with, I wouldn't be able to deal with it through prayer. I wouldn't be able to look at him and see Christ in him. I wouldn't be able to be the woman that I am to him now if I would have had sex with him. And that's just real. Like, I appreciate and love him now more than ever because I didn't have sex with him, because I get to see who he is. So that really would have played a part in our path. Not saying that we wouldn't have, not saying that you won't have purpose if you slipped up and had sex. God always has purpose for us all. And I just feel as though the path that we have together wouldn't have been the same if we had sex in the beginning.
The one thing that I just want to do, I just want to first just thank God for bringing the two of you together. And I just want to thank the two of you for being obedient to what he's called the both of you to. I truly believe that he has some amazing things in store for the two of you. And I hope and pray that you guys continue to stay the course, do as he's called you to do. And I'm grateful. Based on your obedience, you're here not only talking to me, but you're in the ear of so many people right now. People who are questioning whether or not they should live a celibate lifestyle, questioning whether or not it's something that they would be able to do with another person, whether or not it is possible for them to remain sexually pure before getting married. Is there a point of doing it? I think you guys have really spoken some life into people. And obviously, all three of us know that's God speaking through the two of you. And I just want you guys to know that I'm so grateful of your obedience. And, you know, I'll definitely be keeping the two of you in my prayers and just hoping and praying that God continues to strengthen the two of you and you guys are able to do all of the things that he's called you to do.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Jay.
We really appreciate you as well. And we just want to say that it's really refreshing to see someone else and someone else a part of our generation following the will of God. Just you having your radio station and being able to have people, guests on here to share their journey with God and Christ is amazing. So we thank you for following your purpose as well.
Really appreciate it, man.
Hey, real lovers.
I'm Will.
I'm Dom. And that's how we came up with Will and Dom. So we have a YouTube channel called Will and Dom. Just type it in and there we go. That's our channel and it is our ministry on how to remain celibate in a relationship.
Yeah, we also have a website, willanddom.com. You know, we can check it out. We have a power. We have blogs. We also have our, everything that to keep up with us, how to contact us. You know, it's all up there on our website.
Yes. So we are excited and thank you for listening.
Trust and believe, man. The honor is all mine. I'm so grateful that God even allowed our paths to cross. I'm so grateful for it. The things that you've shared here, extremely helpful to me. I know you guys have blessed the real lovers. And the one thing that I'm curious about, are there any books or any resources that the two of you would recommend to any couples out there who want to maintain their sexual purity as well before they get married?
We're actually working on an ebook. We don't know when it's going to be released yet, but we are working on it. So just look out for it. We just launched our website called willanddom.com. So it's www.willanddom.com. So that's where you can find our blogs that we actually post. And we have our actual shirts that's coming out that has pray on the front and respect your temple on the back. So that also would be there. So our website is a great way to see like different stuff that we write, up and coming events, anything of that nature to stay connected with us and what we're doing for Christ. And we also have a YouTube ministry. You know, I know you said, you know, writing like things like books and stuff, but we have a YouTube ministry where people can watch and we share a lot of what we talked about tonight on our YouTube. And that YouTube is called Will and Dom. So those are just the different things that we have, the different networks that we have and work to just sharing what we're about and our ministry and to encourage people to remain celibate and what we do to remain in a celibate relationship.
Yeah, the things that you guys are doing, amazing. Real Lovers, y'all definitely need to check out their YouTube channel. Go check out their website as well. You guys, great videos. I'm telling you, the way that you put them together is unique. I've never seen anything like it before. And like you said, you guys are just yourselves. You keep things 100. And I love that. I love the transparency. I love the honesty. Similar to how we do here on Right to Real Love Radio, you're not afraid to talk about those topics, address those questions that people have and that oftentimes people shy away from. So I just say continue doing what you're doing. It's touching and reaching the right people. And I truly believe that it will continue to do that. The one thing that I did want to do is provide you both with the opportunity. Are there any questions that you would like to ask me personally, or do you feel like there's a certain aspect of this topic that we didn't get into that you feel like we should touch on before we wrap up?
I feel like you did an amazing job tonight, Jay. Like, you know, the questions was really insightful, and we had a pleasure answering them and being transparent. You know, you did awesome. We really don't have anything to say. We just to thank you for having us on.
Yeah, just very grateful, you know, and when we got the message from you, you know, from watching the YouTube video that we put out, it was just like, wow, like, we're actually creating an impact. And, you know, it came with a lot of fear, like, you know, if we do this YouTube video, we're putting our life out there, but we just believe, like, you know what, people are going to be touched by this, you know, we're doing this for our Heavenly Father and, you know, not for ourselves, so... You know, just starting to see, like, when you just put God first and, you know, you start living by His will and not your own, that He is going to use you. You will be His vessel. So, you know, it just came to a thing like, don't have no fears. You know, God does not give us a spirit of fear, you know, but of a sound mind. So, you know, just walk in His footsteps. And, you know, as many out there that probably listening of probably want to create their ministry or want to help people out there. You know, the thing is, just start. Trust me, like, God will use you. He will give you the strength that you need or whatever you need to talk, you know, to be out there and be an impact to our generation out there. And yeah. We really need it. We really need it.
Oh, yeah. No question about that, man. And I'm grateful to have had this opportunity. The things that you guys have shared, extremely helpful. And there's actually only one thing that comes to mind is that I would love for you to leave the Real Lovers and the listeners with. Is those people out there who may be considering doing what you guys are doing and they want to know, how do I prepare? How do I put myself in a position where I can do this once I'm in a relationship? What kind of insight would you leave them with in regards to preparing themselves to one day be able to do what you guys are doing?
For me, my mindset had to change. So I knew for my mindset had to change. I had to stop doing a lot of things. Like, you know, I stopped watching any type of thing that would disrupt my mind, like any type of pornography, anything that will please my flesh, because I knew that, you know, now I'm trying to deny my flesh. So it's like a preparation that took place into me, like, you know what, if I'm going to be celibate, I have to learn how to deny my flesh and all these little desires I have in my heart, you know, to just make sure I've subsided, you know, because now I'm transforming as a new creature, you know, to live for Christ.
And for me, like, one of the things that I feel like is preparation is prayer. Like, I feel like you have to have a prayer life to get through this. And it has to develop before you get through it. I mean, before you make the decision to be celibate, because you're going to need the strength from prayer. Another thing that I feel like is a preparation is to ask God and let Him show you signs if the person that you are intending to be celibate with is really who He intends you to be with. Because a lot of times we try to make the person do what we want it to do, and we try to make the person be on our same page. But when you start to do this journey, you have to make sure that person is really on your same page and really is going down the path that you're going, or you're going to always bump heads. So for preparation, I suggest that you have talks with your celibate partner, and you guys, you know, like I said, do the list and make sure you have a prayer life together and separately, and just make sure that you're not doing it for each other, to please each other, but you're doing it to please God. Because, you know, when you do it to please each other, it's like, you know, it's not as impactful, you know, it's not as, like, you know, special. But when you're doing it to please God, it's a certain thing you hold for yourself. It's something that, you know, if you fall, you really feel convicted about, because, you know, God is just not a man. He's everything. So I just feel like just do it for yourself, do it for God. And when you find the right person that's doing it for themselves and doing it for God, then everything will go according to what God needs it to be.
Yeah, be equally yoked. Like I always say, if you find somebody, you ask them, hey, let's be celibate, and they run away, then, you know, you probably just saved yourself a heartache, you know. Just make sure that you find somebody that wants to grow and wants to do it with you. Don't complicate it for yourself, you know. Find somebody who just wants to take that adventure and that leap of faith with you. Like, you'll be satisfied.
Wow, you guys, perfect way to close out the show. It has been an absolute pleasure speaking to the two of you, and I would love to have you guys come back on, dive into another great discussion if that's something that the two of you would be interested in doing again.
Definitely.
I love that. That's what I'm talking about. I felt that. Y'all did that in unison. We're going to have to make it happen then. So thank you both again. I really appreciate it.
You're welcome. Have a blessed night.
Real lovers, I hope you guys have enjoyed having this opportunity to hear from a couple who is living a celibate lifestyle. They got really open, really transparent, and I'm so grateful for that. Thank you, Will and Dom. Real lovers, I want to ask you to please go show them some love and support. They have an outstanding, outstanding YouTube channel. I will have the link to it, as well as their social media, their website, all of that good stuff over on righttorealove.com. So please check them out. They do, like I said, they do really great videos. So if you're into videos, if you're into YouTube, check out Will and Dom. Subscribe to their channel. You will not be disappointed. I just love them. I can't wait to have them back on the podcast. And I just want to encourage you guys to go to righttorealove.com. Leave us any comments or any questions that you may have. Check their information out, and definitely do that by going in the show notes for every episode that's a part of this series. Real lovers, we got another great one coming up, so make sure you guys don't miss it. Until then, stay blessed, live, and love life. Thank God for another podcast. Deuces!